the sirens went off, and I brought the kids down here into the basement, and then the power went out, and the winds were getting pretty bad. And so then once I heard the windows breaking upstairs, I threw blankets over both the kids, and then I just kind of got over them. And then it was seconds before just the whole house came down on top of us. We were right there where the washer and dryer are. The kids came out fairly unscathed. Little bumps and bruises, scratches. I took something to the top of my head. I have 12 staples in the top of my head right now. We're okay. That's what matters. We're okay. Everybody's okay, in my household at least. This was my house, and this was the basement, and it picked my house up and dropped it right there. That's what's left of my home. We're going to rebuild. The insurance company said it was going to take 12 to 18 months. So basically, we're going to have to start from scratch. We're going to have to buy all the basics all over again. Clothes, toiletries, you know, food. We lost everything.
All this was houses. This is one of the, about right in the center of where the tornado hit, I think, is this line right here. Because you can see, you go around town and there's lots of damage, but right, this trail right here is where you see all the houses that have just disappeared. This tornado was so strong that it couldn't have survived anything, you know. A big metal building like this is tore up like it was candy. Right now, these young people over here are trying to help me dig stuff out. Since I did have a store here, there's still a lot of stuff laying under there that ain't broke. Man, you're finding it all, girls. It's something like this, you know, it takes time to clean it all up. It's going to be a lot of years before this town gets back to normal. We'll have to plant new trees. I'll be dead and gone before it's all normal.
you know, we've had a lot of destruction and damage across the state, and hopefully we'll meet the criteria to qualify. They have policies and metrics in place, and we're going to do everything we can to get that declaration.
And you can see what was left of the homes in a lot of the areas, and especially the downtown area where so many homes were impacted, right next to the hospital.
We did receive the request from the governor just today for the expedited major disaster declaration, and we are working through that, and we will process that as quickly as we can. But me being on the ground here today really helps me understand the actual impact. And as much as I've been watching the videos and seeing the pictures of the tornado damage, it just does not do it justice. When